wrong.
Oh, hi, my name is April, and you.
Billy. To vanquish evil at 3:30 and justice for all on the People's Court at 4:30 on the Leader, Channel 7.
Meanwhile, a less prestigious but equally important crew is packing up the trash. Tons of it scattered everywhere you look. It'll take
Contraption. We're going to see some classic moments from Walt Disney's best-loved films. You at home can play along as we ask our studio team's questions.
On
Contraption, we're going to see some classic moments from Walt Disney's best-loved films. You at home can play along as we ask our studio team's questions about
this is CBC North.
Station is animals. So
who's got the dog out?
Pick up a passport and let's play Contraption.
Today on Contraption, we're going to see some classic moments from Walt Disney's best-loved films. You at home can play along as we ask our studio team's questions about these films. Our categories are books, animals, heroes and villains, and magic. And to run the proceedings, here's our commissioner of Contraption, Ralph Harris.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And thank you, Miranda. Hi, everybody. Our stage is set. We have some great prizes, some wonderful kids who are here to win them, and here come our Contraption coaches, Kevin and Robin, with today's team. Our teams were randomly selected before the show. Hi, kids. And Kevin is the coach of the Red Firebirds. Let's meet the team.
Hi, my name is Noah. I'm gonna go up to Panama.
Okay.
Hi, my name's Dan Hickworth, and I got three famous cats.
Hi, my name is Mark Bailey, and I'm going to be famous when I grow up.
Well, let's hear it, Red Firebirds. Okay. Robin is the coach of the Blue Dragsters, and let's meet them.
Hi, my name is Brandon Openfield, and my friends call me Brandini.
Hi, my name is Lewis, and I won a trophy for poultry.
Hello, my name is Renee, and I'm going to be a bagger when I grow up.
Well, let's hear it, Blue Dragsters! I'd say we've got two great teams here today, and kids, we're glad you're with us. Good luck to everybody. Now, we've placed three passports in each team's bank. Inside each passport is the name of the first station our kids will be going to today. So, kids, head to the dugout, pick up a passport, and let's play Contraption! Our first station is books. So, whose passport says books? Come on over. Well, it looks like Lewis for the Blue Dragsters, I think, and Noel for the Red Firebirds. Well, let's see, Noel. Oh, can I get you to turn around this way? There you go. Let's say hello. And you want to go to Mars, you said?
Yeah. My name is Noel. I'm going to go to Planet Mars.
Well, what do you want to go to Mars for?
I want to see them snakes and coyotes.
Snakes and coyotes on Mars. Are you sure?
Yes.
Who told you that?
My mom.
Okay, well, good luck when you get to Mars. I don't know if there's life there, but you ready to play the game?
Yes.
All right, we'll play in a minute, but first let's say hello to Lewis, who won a trophy for reciting a poem. Would you recite it for us?
Things that make us free. Just because you're not like me and I am not like you. She not mean you cannot do the things you want to do. She not mean you cannot be the one you want to be. Happy, laughing, loving, living. Things that make us free.
Well, that was really nice. Congratulations, Lewis, and congratulations on the trophy. You ready to play?
Yep.
Okay, kids. Now, we're all going to be looking at a scene from a classic Walt Disney movie. At the end of the scene, I'm going to be asking you, Noel, and you, Lewis, questions. And every time you give me a right answer, you're going to earn one very valuable contraptile. At the end of the show, the team with the most contraptiles is going to win a bunch of nice prizes. So good luck. We're also going to have a special question just for you at home, so you might want to get a pencil and paper and be ready to write down your answer. Lewis Carroll's wonderful book, Alice in Wonderland, was transformed into a magical film through the genius of Walt Disney. Let's join Alice as she's challenged to a most unusual game by the Queen of Hearts. So kids, turn around, and everybody, eyes on the screen.
Yes, Your Majesty.
Then let the game begin!
Will you please,
I order the game.
Help me.
Chopper!
king. You heard what she said.
All right, what a wonderful scene. Kids, turn around. Lewis and Noel. Now, I'm going to ask questions. Every time you give me a right answer, you're going to hear this sound. And that means you earn one contraptile for your team. And remember, at the end of the show, the team with the most contraptiles, grand prize winner. So good luck. And here we go, starting with Lewis and the blue team. What instrument did the white rabbit use to start the game?
A bird.
Oh, not a bird. It was a horn or a trumpet. Okay, Lewis, here we go. Over to Noel and the red team. What kind of animal did the queen use as a croquet stick?
Hawk.
What was that, Noel?
Hawk.
A hawk. A hawk. Can you be a little more specific?
A bird.
A bird is correct, and a hawk is a bird. The judges took it. Congratulations. First contraptile for the red team. Over to Lewis Blue. When the playing card, the Ace of Hearts, made a mistake, the queen got very angry. What kind of punishment did the queen order for the card?
Take him away.
Take him away. Anything more? Oh, it was off with his head. Good try. Close, but no contraptile. Back to the red team and Noel. What objects did the little hedgehogs become?
A raccoon.
No, they became croquet balls. Okay, kids, that ends the questions for this round, and you got us underway. Now you're going to have a chance to add to your winnings in our exciting jungle boat race. So, coaches, if you'll help the kids get into their jungle boats, we'll get ready for that race. And while they're getting ready, here's that special question we promised just for you at home. In the scene from Alice in Wonderland, the queen tried to hit the hedgehog and missed. Who poked the hedgehog to get it going? Later on, I'll tell you the right answer so you can see how well you did. But right now, let's get to that jungle boat race. Kids, one contraptile to the runner-up, two to the winner, and take off when you hear the whistle. On your mark, get set. There you go. Runner-up. A very close race. Everybody's foot fell off the pedal a little bit, but it was close. Here we go, over here, Lewis. Good race, both of you. Miranda, how many contraptiles has each team earned?
Well, Lewis won one contraptile for the Blue Dragsters, and Noel won three contraptiles for the Red Firebirds.
Well, good going, guys. You can go to the dugout now, put your contraptiles in the team banks, and thanks for a very exciting round that was well played. Our next station is animals. So whose passport says animals? Well, here they come now. It looks like Brandon for the blue team and Deanne for the red team. Come on over here, Brandon. There we go. Let's see, Brandon, you had a camping trip recently. You want to tell us about that?
Yes. Well, we had to sleep in a tent, and our teachers made a funny noise, and we laughed so hard.
And you had a good time on the trip?
Yes.
All right, well, good luck in the game. We'll get there in a minute. But first, let's say hello to Deanne, who does gymnastics. What kind of gymnastics do you do? Do you do tumbling and floor exercises?
I do, straddles. And I do,
a lot of exercises on it, right? Do you have fun with it?
Yeah.
Okay, you ready to play?
Yes, I am.
Okay, kids, here we go. Hound dogs and foxes are usually natural enemies, but that's not true for this lovable pair of animals in Walt Disney's The Fox and the Hounds. Let's watch the beginning of a beautiful friendship. So kids, turn around, and everybody watch closely.
Hey there, Copper. What you sniffing at?
Something I never smelled before, Chief.
Let me see. Ah, shucks, that's easy. The master just cooking grits and fat back. You ought to know that.
Mm-mm. That's not what I smell. I don't know, Chief. It's something else.
Sonny, you got a lot of learning to do about a sniffing and a smelling. Hey, where you going?
I want to find out what that smell is.
Okay, Copper, but the master ain't gonna like you wandering off.
I won't get lost, Chief. I can smell my way back.
Can't tell these young whippersnappers anything.
What we've been tracking.
I'm a fox. My name's Todd. What's your name, kid?
Mine's Copper.
I'm a hound dog.
Gee, I bet you'd be good playing hide and seek. You want to try it, Copper?
Could I use my nose?
Sure.
Okay, now go ahead and close your eyes and count. 1, 2, 3.
No, Copper, you can't speak.
Oh.
Now start again.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
My, look at that. A fox and a hound playing together.
What a nice scene. Okay, Brandon and Ian, turn around. Here we go. Remember, one contrap pile for every correct answer. And we always invite you, if you want to play along, see if you can answer the questions too, come on. We're going to start this time with Brandon and the blue team. Brandon, what animal did the puppy smell?
A fox.
Fox is correct. Contraptile for the blue team. Over to Deanne and the red team. What did the puppy crawl into while he was looking for the fox?
Log.
Correct. A log. Contraptile for the red team. It looks like a good round. Back to Brandon. What insect was the fox chasing?
A bird?
Oh, close, but he was chasing a butterfly. Okay, back to the red team, Deanne. What kind of dog did the puppy say he was?
Hound.
Hound is correct. Another contraptile for the red team, and that ends the questions for this round, kids. You know what that means. It's race time again. This time you'll be racing in the exciting Wheels of Fire. So, coaches, if you'll help the kids into their wheels, one contraptile for the runner-up, two contraptiles for the winning team, and take off when you hear the whistle. Are we ready? Okay, on your mark. Get set. There they go. Red team wins it, Deanne, but a very close race. Come on over here, Deanne. Come on over, Brandon. That was a very good race, both of you. And Miranda, how many contraptiles has each team earned?
Well, Brandon won 2 contraptiles for the Blue Dragsters, and Deanne won 4 contraptiles for the Red Firebirds.
Well, good going to both of you now. You can go to the dugout, put those contraptiles in the team bank, and that was a good round. Very well played. While the kids are going back that way, I'm going this way to our next station, which is Heroes and Villains. And I know that I'm going to have a couple of kids up here to meet me because they're catching on to the game. It looks like Renee for the blue team and Mark for the Red Firebirds. Renee, let's see. You want to be a box girl, you told us. What does a box girl do?
Bag the groceries inside the bag.
Oh, you mean at the supermarket. Do you know somebody who does that now?
No.
Well, why do you want to do that?
I don't know. It's fun.
Looks like fun. Well, good luck. You ready to play?
Yeah.
We'll get it in a minute, but first let's say hi to Mark. And Mark said he's going to become famous. What are you going to do to become famous?
Play soccer and do lots, try to do movies.
Well, do you play a lot of soccer now?
Yeah.
Are you on a team?
Yeah.
You're ready to play Contraption?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good luck to everybody. Here we go, kids. As hungry predators watch, some heroic young people attempt to rescue a helpless animal from deadly quicksand. Let's see what happens in this scene from the Swiss Family Robinson. So kids, turn around. And everybody, eyes wide open.
really got yourself into a mess. All right, boy. Won't hurt you. Easy, boy. Easy. Look at your eye. If we can get him out of here, maybe you won't have to walk all the way.
Not that way. You'll never get him out. I'll get some more branches. Make a path for him. Now, at a time like this, you've got to use your head. Here you are.
Okay, here we go. Renee and Mark, turn around. Now, I did some checking while you guys were watching that scene, and it turns out that the red team is a little bit ahead right now, but that could change. Still a pretty close game, and we're going to start with the blue team and Renee. What kind of animal was trying to get out of the quicksand?
A zebra.
Zebra is absolutely correct. Contrap pile for the blue team. Mark, red team. What kind of weapon was the first boy carrying?
A sword.
Sword is correct. Contraption for the red team. Back to the blue. Renee, four animals were watching the zebra's struggles. Two of them were the jackal and the monkey. Name one of the other two.
A tiger.
Oh, it was close. It was a cheetah. It was a cheetah, but a very good try. We're going back to the red team and Mark. The jackal tried to attack the zebra. What did the boy throw at the jackal?
Rocks.
Rocks is correct. Another contraption for the red team. Back to Renee in the blue. The girl held out a branch to the zebra. What did the zebra do to the branch?
He bit it and she was trying to take it away from him.
Bit it is absolutely correct. Another contraption for the blue team. And finally, Mark, red. What happened to the girl when the zebra let go of the branch?
Fell down.
Fell down is absolutely right. Another contraption for the red team. Good going, kids. That ends the questions for this round. Now a chance to add your winnings in the exciting magic carpet race. So coaches, help them into the magic carpets. Thank you very much. And while they're getting ready, here's the answer to that special home question we asked you earlier. The question from Alice in Wonderland was, the queen tried to hit the hedgehog and missed. Who poked the hedgehog to get it going? The answer is the king. We hope you got it right. But right now, let's get to that exciting magic carpet race. Kids, take off when you hear the whistle. One contraption to the runner-up and two to the winner. On your mark. Get set. There they go. Out there early, boys. What a close race. Red team wins it by a hair. By a hair. What a very close race that was. Come on over here, kids. Mark, that was a great race. Renee, runner-up. Boy, that was close. Miranda, how many contraptiles do we owe these kids?
Well, Renee won 3 contraptiles for the Blue Dragsters, and Mark won 5 contraptiles for the Red Firebirds.
Well, way to go, both of you. Now you can head to the dugout, bank those contraptiles, and that was a very exciting round. Let's hear it, teams. While they're going back there and banking those contraptiles, we're going to go over here and get ready for the bonus round. Now, in the bonus round, every correct answer is worth 5 contraptiles, so this is still anybody's game. It could all change right here. The red team, I think, is still a little bit ahead, but 5 contraptiles for every right answer can change the whole picture. The station is magic, and we've got all the kids from both teams. And it looks like Renee, Brandon, and Lewis for the blue, and Deanne, Mark, and Noel for the red. Is everybody ready? Okay, they're ready. Packing for a journey is usually a pretty hard job, unless you're a wizard and can do it with magic, like Merlin the Magician in The Sword in the Stone. So kids, turn around, and everybody love this with the kids.
Icatus, figatus, somba, kazee. I want your attention to everything.
We're packing to leave. Come on, let's go.
No, no, not you. Foxes are always first, you know. Pockety, pockety, wockety, whack. Abber, abber, and abber, and that. Shrinking size, very small. We got to save enough room for all. Higgitus, higgitus, biggitus, bump. Crested edge and tony, hunky. Malika fez, Malika says, Malika mesberespedy. Wockety, 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 wow. Now stop, stop, stop. See here, sugar boy, you're getting rough. That poor old tea set is cracked enough. Now, all right, let's start again. Where was I, boy?
Hockety-pockety?
Oh, yes, yes, that's right. Pockety-pockety-wockety-whack. Odds and ends and brick and brick. Be with you in just a minute, son. Package almost done.
You bundling blockhead.
Hey, easy then. No, no, go ahead. Dumb poodly doodly doodly dum. This is the best part now. Higgitus figgitus biggitus boom. Prestidigitonium. Higgitus figgitus biggitus boom. Prestidigitonium.
Oh. What a way to pack.
Well, now just a minute, boy. How else would you get all this stuff into one suitcase, I'd like to know?
Okay, kids, turn around. Here we go, and this is going to decide it. Now, remember, in the bonus round, I'll ask each team a question. The whole team gets to huddle together and talk it over and come up with one answer, and I'll ask one of you for the answer, and we're starting with the blue team. Blue team, what got tangled around the wizard's cane when he first tried to do his magic? Okay, you can talk it over. Boy, they were anxious. Okay, we need an answer. Let's see. Renee.
His beard.
His beard is correct. 5 contraptiles to the blue team. Good start in the bonus round. Over to the red team. What objects did Merlin say should always be packed first? Talk it over first, Noelle. Everybody get together, talk it over. Okay, Deanne.
Books.
Books is correct. 5 contraptiles for the red team. Back to the blue. What did Merlin magically do to all his belongings so he could fit them in his bag? Talk it over. They're huddling it in. Okay, we need an answer. Brandon.
Make them small.
Make them small is absolutely right. 5 more contraptiles for the blue team and back to the red. Noelle knows the answer already. Wait till I ask the question. Here we go. Merlin was angry with one object because it got rough with the tea set. What was the object? Talk it over. Talk it over. Mark.
Teapot.
Oh, it was the sugar bowl. The sugar bowl. But a good guess, red team. Okay, back to the blue team. What kind of bird almost got trapped in the shrinking birdhouse? Talk it over. They're ready. Lewis.
Owl.
Owl, you said. Owl is correct. 5 contraptiles for the blue team. And the last question to the red team, Noel. I haven't asked the question yet, Noel. Here it comes. Merlin was standing on the last thing to be packed. When it flew into the bag, Merlin fell on the floor. What had he been standing on? Now talk it over. Talk it over. Okay, we need an answer now. Noelle.
Carpet.
The carpet? No, he was standing on a stool. He had been standing on a stool. Okay, kids, that ends the questions in the bonus round, and now the moment we've all been waiting for. Let's head over to those contrapta counters. Pile on those contraptiles, and we're going to find out who today's winner is. The red team was ahead going in, but that bonus round was pretty tough. I don't know. Let's see. They're off to a pretty good start here, and the blue team is, well, the blue team is up to 3, 4, 5. Red team is moving out fast, emptying their bank. They're up to 11, 13, 14, 15. The blue team is, where's the blue team? Blue team is now at 11. Looks like it's pretty close here. I don't know. Red team has 17. Blue team has 21. The blue team wins it. Congratulations, and Miranda. What have we got in today's prize package for the blue team?
Today, every player wins an LP record album from Listening Fun, a timely black hole wristwatch, a sturdy lunchbox for mealtime good times, a pocket-sized AM radio with its own headset, a professional-style Presto Magic Show game, a set of Wonderful World of Disney books for hours of enchantment, and two tickets for whole day's adventures at Disneyland. Today, each lucky member of our winning team will receive a special grand prize, their very own Texas Instruments home computer for fascinating fun and learning. All for you from Contraption.
Well, congratulations to everybody here, and thank you all very much for watching. We had a lot of fun today. We hope you had a lot of fun, too, and we hope to see you here next time on Contraption. Bye-bye.
The Disney Channel. Share the magic.
Well, that was well played.